Hi, I am Julian Bro. I am an economist and policy specialist. Today, we will talk about the goal of the economy in the long run. I will teach you about saving and investment as a part of the financial system and the system of national accounts. We will start by discussing what is economic growth. We will then talk about investment and savings as a part of national accounts. Finally, we will discuss how these two concepts are linked together through the financial system. Let's start with economic growth. Economic growth is recognized as one of the main goals, if not the main goal, of the economy. It is often cited on the news and in reports by governments. People get really worried when the growth forecasts go down. What does it actually mean? Quite literally, economic growth means that the economy is growing in size. That in a given period of time, it produced more goods and services than in the period before. For instance, you can see in the graph that the US economy was growing between 2012 and 2019. To measure the size of the economy, economists use gross domestic product, or GDP. First, from the perspective of income, GDP is the total market value of all final goods and services produced within a country in a given amount of time. For instance, yearly, or per semester, or per quarter. This means that intermediary goods, that is to say, goods which will in turn be transformed into other goods, are not included in GDP. But how do we know how large is the GDP of a given country in a given year? There are three approaches to measuring it. The first one is based on added values. Companies produce value added. GDP is then equivalent to the sum of all the value added of all the companies based in the country. The second one is based on incomes. To measure GDP, we can add up all the incomes of all the producers in the country. A third way is to add up all the ways in which GDP is spent. This is a nation's expenditures. For simplicity, let's assume that we are in a closed economy that doesn't have imports or exports. This gives this equation, where GDP equals the sum of the consumption of households, C, investments by firms, I, and government expenditures, G. Government spending is, for instance, spending on education, healthcare, or welfare benefits. Since nothing disappears in the economy, everything that is earned is spent. So, incomes are equal to expenditures. All this activity that we are talking about is recorded in the system of national accounts. Income and expenditure approaches, or the ways to measure the current state of the economy. But how do we foster economic growth in the long run? We can do so by investing more. This is how it works. Investment means expenditures on capital. For example, buying new equipment, building more production, or investing in automation. All these expenditures increase productivity. So, for a given level of inputs, our economy now produces more outputs over a given period of time. This increase in the values of outputs constitutes economic growth. Let's move on to investments and savings in national accounts. Understanding the amount of investments in the economy at any given period of time in our model is quite straightforward. Remember that national income, Y, in a closed economy is a sum of consumption, C, government spending, G, and investment, I. Let's rearrange the equation to get the value of investment. The value of investment is equal to national income after consumption and after government spending. Where are the investments coming from? They are coming from savings. Let me show you how this works. There are two types of savings in the economy. Private savings is equal to household income after paying taxes to the government and after all consumption spending. The government also can save. Public savings are the difference between the incomes of the government, that is, the taxes which are received, and the expenditures of the government. When we sum the private savings of households and the public savings of the government, we obtain national savings. You can see that taxes cancel out when we open the brackets. National savings are equal to all incomes minus consumption and minus government spending. And they are exactly equal to the amount of investments in the economy. The financial system is the group of institutions that helps match savings and investments. Those are, for instance, commercial banks, stock exchanges, or central banks. In this way, the financial system helps to allocate scarce resources in the economy at any given time in the most efficient way, promoting economic growth. There are two main types of financial institutions: financial markets and financial intermediaries. Financial markets allow savers to directly provide funds to borrowers, for instance, through buying stocks and bonds. Financial intermediaries, such as banks, allow savers to fund borrowers indirectly. Savers provide funds to banks, and banks provide them as loans to borrowers. Time for a quick exercise. Use national accounts to derive the quality of savings and investments. Remember that saving is a sum of private and public saving. Private saving is equal to household income after tax and consumption. Public saving is the difference between taxes and government spending. Total savings are equivalent to total income minus consumption and government spending. We derive the value of investment from the GDP equation. National income equals the sum of consumption, government spending, and investment. Rearranging for investment, we get that investment is equal to income minus consumption minus government spending, which is equivalent to savings. A quick recap. The most widely recognized aim of the economy is stable economic growth, by which we mean an increase in the size of the economy, or the GDP. An increase in investments leads to an increase in productivity that results in GDP growth. In our model, investments are coming from savings through the financial system. The financial system matches public and private savings to investments. Today, we talked about economic growth, how it can be fostered, and what the role of the financial system is. I hope you enjoyed today's video.